So last hour, we were witness to an exhilarating achievement by NASA, a step toward a planetary defense system. The space agency deliberately slammed a spacecraft into an asteroid to change its course. It'll be some time before we know how successful the mission was, but this is what it looked like from the camera on board the craft as it approached the asteroid, as well as a very excited mission control.
Yeah. Oh my goodness. Eight, yeah. Seven, oh, six, wow. Five, four, three, two, one.
Oh my gosh.
Oh wow. Awaiting visual confirmation.
All right. We got it?
Waiting.
Waiting.
And we have impact. A family for humanity in the name of planetary defense.
Those are some pretty jazz scientists right there. I'm joined now by legendary astrophysicist Neil deGrasse Tyson of the American Museum of Natural History joins me now. He's also author of the new book, Starry Messenger, Cosmic Perspectives on Civilization. So hitting this asteroid was successful. It hit what it was aiming at. But what will NASA determine to figure out how successful it was, if it worked to push this asteroid away?
So it's not an isolated asteroid. It's a moonlet of a much larger asteroid. And they actually have a little gravitational dance that they do where the moonlet orbits the larger asteroid. And so a lot of thought went into what would be the best way to test if we can deflect an asteroid. And once you have a very well calculated and measured orbit, if you now give it a nudge, it was a head-on collision in this case, then you can then see what has happened to the orbit after that collision. And so it's brilliantly conceived and designed. I just think we should have been doing this decades ago.
So the part that I can't get past is that we need a planetary defense system. This is a dry run to test technology in case an asteroid is headed to Earth that poses a threat to humankind. You know, what's the chance of that actually happening?
Well, you can bet that if the dinosaurs had NASA, they would have deflected that asteroid that took them out 65 million years ago. So I don't want to be the laughing stock of the galaxy to be the only species to not only be smart enough to be able to deflect an asteroid, have a space program in place to do so, and then not do so and go extinct because of it. That would just be embarrassing, I think, for me as a species. So yeah, these are baby steps right now, just to see if it works, all right? To see if we have the power to do this. And then when the big one comes, you wanna make sure that there's enough of these practice runs that in fact, we would end up succeeding. Notice it's deflecting it, it's not blowing it out of the sky, as in so many cinematic scenarios have portrayed. You know, in America, you know, we're good at blowing stuff up and less good at knowing where the pieces go afterwards. So a deflected asteroid is far more sensible in what it would require to protect our species.
I like the fact that embarrassment is high on your list of concerns during an extinction event. It may be a little bit lower on my list there, but I do appreciate that you have that feeling as an astrophysicist. So if an asteroid were headed to Earth, would NASA be able to replicate this mission, or would it, you know, tailor what it does to a specific threat?
Yeah, of course you would have to tailor it. And the catch here is you want to discover the threat as early as possible. So it might be we get an asteroid, then 1,000 orbits from now, it might hit Earth. Well, maybe that's early enough so that you just nudge it maybe 1 centimeter per second to the left or to the right, all right, in some direction that it's not otherwise headed. And once you give it that extra speed, that speed just accumulates in the deflection angle, and you can, with relatively little investment of energy, have an asteroid completely miss Earth. Mm. If you get it early enough. And so a big effort of NASA now is cataloging the asteroids that are what we call near-Earth threats, near-Earth objects. And once you get a full catalog of those, then you track them. And once you track them and you get one discovered, that's when you go into effect. But I'd rather we had this ready even before we discover such a threat. I feel better about it.
I feel better just talking to you about it. Neil deGrasse Tyson, thank you very much for joining us this evening. Always a pleasure.
And by the way, you know that movie, Don't Look Up? To me, that was a documentary, so I worry about that.
Right.
Where everyone was in denial.
Neil, thank you very much. And a reminder, Neil's new book, Starry Messenger, Cosmic Perspectives on Civilization, is coming out.